Hey, this is Justin with DayTradeTheMarkets.com on Monday, March 4th, 2013, and I wanted to kind of get back to basics in the video tonight and really talk about what we consider to be the first building block of making sense of the market, and that is what we call relative aggression bars. And then I want to specifically focus in on what we call level three relative aggression bars. Before I do that, and I want to show it from a lot of different perspectives, from a 15-second chart all the way up to a 15-minute chart. Okay, and I just want to show you how those level three relative aggression bars really frame the market and help you stay on the right side of things, so that number one, you can avoid getting into bad trades that where you don't have edge on your side, and number two, you can get into more good trades. So, with that said, let me give a little bit of some background here on the different components that we look at. In our software, again, we have some real-time information here to here. We also like to look at the bigger picture bias, bigger picture levels, and kind of put that within the context of what's happening in real time. So, but within the real-time auction, we look at some relative aggression bars, high velocity moves, support resistance zones, deceleration, and so forth. For example, if we look at this chart here, this happens to be the E-mini S&P on a 5-minute chart, and we're looking at the last 2 days. So here is Monday, here is Friday. And if you just break down the different components, you can see we have these different colored paint bars. The dark green are what we call level two or strong buying aggression. Here's high velocity moves, these boxes. The light pink, light green are what we call level one bars. These dark blue and dark magenta are what we call level three aggression bars. Down here at the bottom of the screen is a directional filter. So you can, and that goes from neutral to bullish, strongly bullish, and so forth. There's also a bearish and strongly bearish. And then you can see these red and green zones here are what we call real-time support resistance zones. So in other words, all things equal, this is an area you'd want to think twice before buying, and it's all things equal, a good place to be a seller. This is an area that you'd want to think twice before selling, and all things equal, it'd be a good area to be a buyer. And then these diamonds and circles are what we call decelerations, and those are pretty minimal indicators, but they're just telling us really short-term potential turning points in the market where, you know, in real time, for example, you know, this bar has a higher high than this bar, but the level of buying aggression within that bar is actually slowing down or decelerating. So all things equal, it should be at least a very short-term turning point, for example. So that's the idea there. And the idea here is that the more of these pieces that come together, the better sense you can make of the market. So for example, if our bigger picture bias is up and our filter's green and we have a green support zone, there's a lot of pieces of evidence coming together. Or if we get a level three buying aggression bar with follow through with a green filter after we've touched on support or making new highs, just, you know, you're trying to put these pieces together, and this is the training that we do. And so to go back and look at that a little more in depth, if we take this idea of looking at relative aggression bars as our kind of our first building block, then just to give a little bit more information about that, what these relative aggression bars are telling us that is when one side, by one side I mean buyers or sellers, is more aggressive than the other. And that's what truly moves the market, is when one side is collectively more aggressive than the other. And that, you know, what these bars are doing, and they're telling us, number one, which side is more dominant? Are buyers or sellers more aggressive at a given moment in time? And then number two, more importantly, to what degree are they more aggressive? Are they moderately more aggressive, strongly more aggressive, or extremely more aggressive? And by looking at what happens after one of these bars forms, it gives us a very, very good, what we call, roadmap to the likely short-term direction of the market. So what I want to do now is take off everything, take off the support resistance zones, take off the filter, and just look at these level three aggression bars on several different charts, and let's have a look at how those kind of give you a bit of a roadmap to the market. Okay, so again, here's the 5-minute chart with all of the different components on there: filter, support resistance zones, decelerations, all the different high velocity moves, the different shades of aggression bars. What I'm going to do now is take off everything but the level three bars. So all you're going to see are just these level three bars, and I'll go back further in time so we can see more, and let's get a pretty good feel for what that tells us. Okay, so here's a chart with nothing but level three bars on there. Again, it's a 5-minute chart. I'm going to show a bunch of different time frames in just a second. Here was today or Monday. Here was Friday, Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday of last week, and so forth. And what you can see here is, here is Friday. At the end of Friday, we had a level 3 buying aggression bar. We gapped up. On Monday, we had this level 3 selling aggression bar. And so we ask ourselves, is there follow through or is there rejection? In other words, do we continue lower? Is this high maintained? As long as that high is maintained, or in other words, until that high is breached or something on the right side of the chart, some buying aggression comes in, we have to think that sellers are in control of this market. So then we get more level three extreme selling. And you can see we sell off numerous points. Here's at the very end of the day, have some follow through, and then overnight, open back up above that. Here's another level 3 bar. We do have a little bit more continuation, but that doesn't really hold. And you can see that as soon as this high is taken out, you know, which had a little bit of a two-step there, so that was a little bit of a confusing one. But when that high is taken out, and you know, there were some level 2 and such bars in there. I'm just trying to make it simple in this case. Then we have the level 3 bar to open that day, level 3 bar with continuation, level 3 selling bar with rejection. So again, showing us buyers are in control. Level 3 bar, level 3 bar at the beginning of the next day. That as long as that low is maintained or is kept, buyers are in control of this market until something else comes in. At the end of the day, something else did come in, some level 3 selling. You can see that followed through overnight. And again, as long as that high is maintained or other evidence comes in, and you can see this high essentially is maintained until today when other evidence started to come in. Okay, some strong buying aggression. And again, if we kind of we can scroll back in time more, and you can see, you know, on this day, rejection of this level 3 selling bar. Okay, buyers are in control. And again, this is a 5-minute chart, so you can use this kind of give you a framework for day trading, or you could just trade off of this 5-minute chart. Okay, you can see here that the prior day, some strong selling comes in. This selling is rejected. That's telling us this market's a bit two-sided. Then, you know, until before this one, high is taken out, we have another level 3 bar that comes in. Its high was tested on the next bar. Sells off the rest of the day. So it's just that kind of idea where you're using these level 3 bars. And that, again, that's just the first building block. You saw on the prior charts that I showed, there's a lot of other evidence that you can work with. I'm just trying to show this basic first building block, these level 3 bars, because they do give you such a good roadmap for what's going on. Let me show you on a little bit longer time frame chart. Okay, this is a 15-minute chart. And I think this is a great swing trading chart and also a great chart, or time frame, I should say, for really giving you an overview, big picture, if you're doing day trading. So you can see back on the 25th, some strong selling came in off the highs. Just continued. It's not until we get toward the end of this day where some buying starts to come in. Okay, the next day we have selling until we get some buying to match that. Selling, now we get a buying rally. The selling is rejected. Now this buying on the high, it's interesting, we tested, this is a pretty good known area of resistance, as this is where strong selling came in. This is where that vertical move began. So it would stand to reason that the high, or where strong selling came in, would be a pretty good area of resistance. And you can see we tested into that level, couldn't get any follow through, attracted more selling. And now we're doing a bit of a two-step here where we're back with some buying aggression. We test to the middle of that. And then today we have buying aggression and take out this bigger picture level that we were looking at. And if you looked at the support resistance zone this on the 15-minute chart, there's a big resistance zone that's right in here that we've just taken out. So bigger picture, if we can maintain this and even test into the 1530 area up here, that's a pretty bullish indication, bigger picture, for the market. But again, the point being, What happens when one of these level 3 selling or buying bars comes in? Is there follow through? Okay, if there's follow through, then bears in this case are in control until there's other evidence. Here's the other evidence. Okay, buying evidence. Until something else comes in, like a rejection or another piece of selling evidence that comes in, then buyers are in control. So again, that's over the course of, you know, nearly 2 days. So it looks like nothing on this chart, but over the course of 2 days, that's a pretty good handle on the directionality of the market. So you can stay out of being on the wrong side of the market a lot more easily. And obviously, that's job one. Now let's look at here's a 1-minute chart. And you can see that this is the beginning of today. No extreme aggression, and it's a choppy day. Here's some extreme aggression that came in around 1:25 or so Eastern time. Follow through. This market's now in control of the buyers. Same thing a little bit later on, and then again toward the close. So it's giving you on the short term a very good indication that the bulls are taking over. Okay, so it's the same idea. It doesn't matter if you're looking at a 60-minute chart, if you're looking at a, well, let me show you a 15-second chart, a kind of a what I call micro time frame chart. You know, you got to be careful on this. It's so quick that you have to be a little careful, but it's the same concept. That's what I'm trying to show here. Okay, so again, this is a 15-second chart. You would need to be extremely careful if you're going to use one of these charts. You can kind of get really caught up in the very, very short term. But if that's your style, if you're a really quick scalper, then this can be very helpful. You can see right after noon Eastern time, level 3 selling bar with follow through. Okay, then we have some buying that comes in around 1:15 on the 15-second chart. Okay, you can see that, you know, we have a little bit of selling that stops that wave. A little bit of selling here stops that wave. And then toward the end of the day, we get some more aggressive level 3 buying. So again, we were just looking at, instead of looking at all of the components, like this chart, for example, where you've got, the filter, the support zones, all the different colored aggression bars, and you could look at this on any time frame. I was just trying to show on different time frames, and this would work on any market, any time frame, what those level 3 bars can do. They really help you get a sense for when something major is coming into the market. So, you know, as a first building block, that's what we like to look at. If there's extreme buying or selling aggression that's coming in, and it's either accepted, in other words, it has continuation, or it's rejected, that's giving us with an extremely high degree of accuracy, not 100%, but a very high level of accuracy, the short-term direction of the market at that time, which is obviously pretty good information that you can use to help you, you know, make better trading decisions. And after all, that's, you know, as traders, that's our job, is to make better decisions. Hopefully that makes sense. And obviously, if you look at other markets or have other time frames or whatever the case may be, and you want me to send you a chart, I'd be happy to do that. Just let me know. Again, the idea here is that these level 3 bars alone are just the first building block, and as you get more experience and spend some more time with the software, you add other components and really try to make sense of what's going on in that sense. But the first building block are these level 3 bars, and just them alone can really help you increase your edge. So hopefully that makes sense. If you have any questions about that, let me know, and we'll talk soon. Thanks.